In question 3 of the series, you'll notice that the equation is in terms of y, as opposed to the previous two questions where it was in terms of x. As a result of this, our formula for the length of the arc will change slightly. Take a look at the difference. Here we have dx with respect to dy, whereas in the previous question, it was dy with respect to dx. That being said, let's start by taking the derivative of this function with respect to dy, substitute it into here, then take the integral of that function. The steps that I just mentioned are outlined right here. And unlike the previous question, the integrand that we need to find the integral of afterwards isn't straightforward. So we have this rule for that type of function, which we'll use as well. Let's start with the first step, which is to find the derivative. We have x is equal to 4y squared. Now finding the derivative with respect to y, we get dx over dy is equal to, I'm going to use the power rule here, 8y 2 minus 1 is 1, and I'll substitute 8y into here, where we have s that represents the length between the bounds 0 and 4, that's taken from the question, the square root of 1 plus 8y to the power of 2 dy. Now that we have set up the equation, I can do a u substitution, where I set u is equal to 8y. I'm setting only this equal to u. Let's take the derivative of this equation with respect to y. We get du is equal to 8 dy. Solving for dy, I get dy is equal to du over 8. I'll replace this dy with du over 8, and look what happens. We end up with s is equal to the integral between 0 and 4, 1 plus u to the power of 2, and this becomes du over 8. I can pull out 1 over 8. That doesn't need to be integrated. S is equal to 1 over 8, the integral between 0 and 4 for the square root, and I'll just rearrange this so that it looks and models this known integral, u to the power of 2 plus 1. Now that we've modeled the integrand to look like this, I'm going to replace all of this with this expression, giving us s is equal to 1 over 8 square brackets, and everything here, u over 2, and remember, u is set as 8y, 8y over 2, the square root of 8y to the power of 2, which is 64y squared, plus 1, plus 1 to the power of 2 is 1, so that's half, ln the absolute of 8y plus the square root of 64y squared plus 1, close the absolute, and now we can evaluate at 4 and 0. If you evaluate this correctly, in other words, if you substitute 4 into wherever you see a y, find the answer, and then substitute 0 wherever you see the y, find its answer, and subtract the 2, then multiply by an eighth, you should get an arc length that's approximately 64.3 units. And there you have it. That is how to calculate the arc length of a function with integrals.